Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers, Breakdown, and that's for Carl's behaviour last week. Carl, you seem to be a little bit happier. Last week, I mean, we were worried about you. You sort of slipped into some sort of like weird depression. You played Placebo twice, so you weren't concentrating. I know what you're gonna say that me and Steve were annoying you, but you know, that's an easy excuse. I mean, I think the listener can make up their own mind.
No. It's just like I say though, it's like a murderer, right? He might not have done that if it was a different day, if the sun was out, whatever. And everything just happened at once that wound me up.
Right. So it was like a crime of passion. You'd be let off because those sort of circumstances. You'd never put yourself, say, in a position again where we'd have two people trying to wind you up for, you know, the sake of fun and laughter for the public on a tin pot radio station between 1 and 3 every Saturday.
Yeah, but
you'd never do that again, would you?
Last week it wasn't just for the listeners, it was for you as well, between 12 and 1. Because we were even on the air.
Why?
You were winding me up then, do you know what I mean?
Having a discussion.
It's alright, I'm used to it, so it doesn't matter. But so I found out that I can't do this job anymore, I can't do these sort of jobs where you've got to be happy all the time.
Well, you don't have to be happy all the time.
No, you do.
You forget that for the.
Yeah, but I can't. Do you know what I mean? I've got things going on in my head. And
do you think when Bobby Davros had a bad day that he doesn't go on stage and give 100%?
No, but that's.
Do you think Les Dennis let all that stuff get in his way when he did that theatre tour to the people in front?
He had audiences of 7, 8, 15 people.
Yeah, and he just went, it's them. It's not my private life. Forget that. Bang!
Yeah, but good on him, yeah. he can do that, but what I'm saying is I can't.
He's a professional.
So I was talking to Suzanne about it, because, you know, it did get me down last
week. Suzanne's your therapist?
To her, you know, I can't do this sort of job. Normally what I do in the week, you know, I'm tucked away in a studio. If I'm annoyed, no one knows about it, I get my head down, I get on with it.
Wait, do you tell him? Go on, next.
You know what I mean?
Next.
Right, but what's your point here? So every Saturday you've got to come here,
you've got to be happy, we've got to go, oh Carl, are you alright? Oh, you're right. Your hair looks nice.
No, but you know what I mean? That's the first time, innit? Normally people listening go, he's a happy fella, do you know what I mean?
They never think you're a happy fella, Carl. They've never heard you laugh. No one has ever- seriously, we get emails all the time, no one's ever heard you laugh.
Yeah, but I'm still happy, you don't have to-
Well, are you?
Yeah.
You don't look happy.
But anyway, that's the problem with this job. And, I was thinking about it, if do you know, like, if you're a doctor?
Sure.
And you're on a plane and something happens.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Even though you're on holiday.
Yeah. You might have to save someone's life just because you can. Next!
And I'd be thinking, I'll keep quiet.
Sure.
I love that! Yeah. See, that's one of the reasons why you didn't actually qualify.
as a surgeon.
I mean, you can still do your consultancy stuff.
Oh, sure,
But, you know, you just don't actually have a knife in your hand anymore. Brilliant. So you're giving this up, are you?
Sorry, and how is a doctor on a plane comparable to this?
Because it's just the same situation, do you know what I mean? He's probably got in his head, he's shut off, he's ready for his holiday.
He's going to Hastings for a night.
Someone, you know, has a little bit of tummy trouble or heart attack or whatever.
Yeah.
And is he a doctor on the plane? And he's like,
Jesus,
going on holiday. You know what I mean?
I've got to loosen his tie.
Yeah.
I can't do
that. But what I don't understand, Carl, is you get paid to do this. It's not like we're forced, it's not like it's your holiday. You know that this is your job of work.
This is paying for your new kitchen.
Exactly.
Yeah, but I've got the kitchen now. It's done, isn't it?
Right. Yeah. So when are you stopping?
When are you quitting?
Well, you're finishing, aren't you, in a couple of weeks for a bit?
No,
so
about four.
Yeah,
we're finishing on the 16th of August, yeah. But, you know, we're only going away for like 6 or 7 weeks again, aren't we?
Well, you don't know yet, do you?
Well, we'll give up if you give up. Tell your managing directors that.
Well, that's a bit annoying.
Why?
Because you've just passed the buck, haven't you?
I haven't passed the buck. This is three-way, you know, you get your name in heat, you're in the title now. It's Ricky Gervais, Steve Merchant and Carl Pilkington. And now you want to go, I don't want to do it anymore.
Well, Carl,
I don't know whether
you've noticed, but we don't provide anything on this show. So if you leave, we have to go.
let's put a song on.
Now, just think, don't be so selfish. Don't be so selfish. Yeah. We need you. Yeah. We've got nothing.
Molly's Chambers, Kings of Leon. Brilliant. On XFM 104.9. So, I'm not gonna put pressure on you, Carl. I know you're scared to be saying this, right? But, I'll tell you what we do, right? We're stopping this show on the 16th of August. We're gonna film the Office specials, okay? And we'd be coming back, I don't know, August, September, middle October.
Mm-hmm.
If Carl does.
Yeah.
No, I know that's pressure, but that's it. I think it is. I think this is a three-way show. So you don't have to do it. We, what should we do? Because I know we've been approached by a couple of others. What would you do?
We've been approached by, obviously, better radio stations. I mean, just think of, if you're a listener, just think of any of the radio stations you prefer to listen to. That's some of the ones that have offered us gigs. So we could toy with those.
Or we stay and we see this through and we get XFM on the map. We'll get a few sounds.
I know, Rick, I know you've had a passion since you started working at XFM to get the listeners into double figures. I know that's one of your ambitions, and I think it would be a shame to give up so soon because you've done so much hard work.
Yeah. That's for you to think about. So we've got, we've got 4 weeks left, and that might be 4 weeks forever and never coming back, or 4 weeks for like an 8 week period, and that's for you to think about. So think if you enjoy the next 4 weeks, Carl.
Yeah, but like I said to you though, the reason I did this.
Yeah.
Was to get that kitchen, right? Now.
Brilliant.
As we speak now, right? Builder's in the flat. He's been annoying me.
Of course he has. Of course he has. What's he been doing?
Well, when he turned up on Monday, right?
Yeah.
Wanders in, and the first thing he says to me is, said, the pub across the road, is it any good? I said, well, it doesn't matter, does it? You're working on the kitchen.
Think of saying that to a builder. Probably making conversation. Probably meant, do they do a toasted sandwich? Because I've got a half-hour lunch break. Not an hour, like Carl Bilkington. So, I'll pop over there and get a nice, you know, cheese and tomato sandwich.
Is that genuinely
what
you said to him?
So Suzanne had a go at me saying, why have you said that? He hasn't even started on it yet.
I cannot believe that.
You're unbelievable, Carl. And you say it's us that are rude, crass,
I wasn't being rude. I just was letting him know. Do you know what I mean? I know what
he knows what he was there for. He had it down on his little docket, do the kitchen this week. Yeah. He didn't come there and go, what did I come out for? Was it to go to the pub for a week?
Why am I wearing these overalls?
Yeah, who's the little bald mank twat insulting me? Let me just check, let me call the head office.
I wasn't having a go though, I mean they should have finished it yesterday, and they're there now, right, on their own. And what annoyed me is they turned up late today.
Hold on, Carl, I've just realised something. They're probably listening to the radio, this I assume tuned to XFM, isn't it, in your kitchen?
Yeah, but... they don't know it's me, do they? You know what I mean?
No. They'd go, he's got a whiny mank voice as well. So's the bloke who owns this place. And the bloke who owns this place, when I said, what's that pub like across the road, said, well, you won't be bothering that, he's working on this. No, he won't be able to put two and two together, will he? You've suddenly, the penny's dropped, hasn't it? You've suddenly realised, look at his face! Yeah. He's suddenly realised they might know it's him!
And they could be listening, and they're gonna clean you out, mate.
Oh, if you are the builder working in, where is it? I won't say the address, but it's...
Central London, isn't
it? Yeah.
Go mental. Have whatever you want.
Opposite
seriously.
Opposite that pub that you like, that you're...
He'll probably be in there now, so he won't be listening.
Oh, insulting. You know insulting a British insult. Workman.
He should have been in today.
Mental.
He should have been at 8 this morning.
Just
which annoyed
go
me anyway.
Mental.
Why, I really don't understand why they've got to start so early, right?
Yeah.
But he said he'll be there for 8, turned up at 9:30, right? Wanders in, and what annoys me is... he could have left all this downstairs. He had a paper under his arm, one of those crossword books, and a pot noodle. Now, I'm not being funny, but most of them took quite a bit of time. A crossword book, he's not happy with just the one that's in the paper.
If you're listening, if you are the builder that's listening now, doing Carl's flat, what about pissing in the laundry basket? Lonesome Day, Bruce Springsteen, on XFM 104.9. So, you've realised now that the builder could well be listening, knowing exactly who you're talking about.
There's a chance of it. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I didn't think about it, but you're right, you know, was tuned onto that. I think he did flick it on, thinking about it, thinking back. If so, yeah, he's probably listening now.
No, he probably isn't. He probably listened to about half hour. If he's got any sense, he turned it to Heart or Virgin or Magic or something. But, you know, there is a chance.
Good advice to the listeners.
Yeah.
If you've got any sense. If you finish your crossword puzzles.
I think, you know, according to our figures, there's a 5% chance of him listening to it.
Yeah.
So, if we, you know, if we want to be accurate. Although he's in a house with it tuned to that, so I think it puts him right up to 50% straight away.
But then again, Rick, he's got a job of work, so why would he be listening to this show?
Well, he's doing a crossword at the moment.
Yeah, well...
You better hope he's not listening.
Well, I mean, they do annoy me. I'm sticking by it.
Yeah, come on, you might as well keep digging. Yeah, go on.
No, I'm just saying, they do annoy me, the way they wake you up at 8 and then...
Well, that's when they start work.
Because I told you, I mean...
Oh, we'll leave that one then. Yeah.
No, but it's like the other day when they came in, I always like to test them. Do you know what I mean? When I had some work done on the last flat that was in, right, that was renting, the builders were in sorting the shower out and that. They woke me up about 7:30.
Yeah.
Right?
Were you in the shower?
No.
Good thing about cleaning this shower, there's never any hair down the plug hole.
Yeah.
Right? So, I left early to come to work, right?
Sure.
And I thought, I wonder what they're doing. I wonder if they have started. So I walked back to go back in. They'd left the flat and they were outside having a Starbucks. And it just annoys me that they couldn't do that first. Do you know what I mean? Have your breakfast first, then come and wake me up. But don't wake me up to then get me out of the flat and then say, right, let's go and have breakfast.
Well, they've probably got to get in, haven't they?
What for? What for? They can put all the tools in the little lobby bit. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Just winds me up.
Sure.
Now, the thing is, the guy today who's doing the tiling, well, that's narrowed it down a bit more, right? When I knew he was in there, I went out for a bit, had a cup of tea and a bacon butty, right? At a cafe. And I went back and I was really quiet, put my key in the door and opened it really quick to see what he'd be doing. And he had actually started work, so fair play to him.
What if he'd just been exfoliating himself naked on the kitchen floor?
Yeah.
I'd say, right, caught you.
If you're listening, go through the wardrobes upstairs.
Go through the wardrobe, get some stuff.
They won't get anything. I've put everything in places where they wouldn't think of looking. But jewellery and stuff.
So you're thinking that
where have you put the jewellery? Where have you
put the jewellery? I'm not saying.
Go on.
So you're thinking that they're going to thieve from you as well?
Okay, so if you're listening, don't think about the obvious places when you're looking for the jewellery.
No. But I do things like, I would do things like, you know, just pop a little bit of urine. Maybe in the salt cellar or something.
Yeah.
Just do something.
I'd say what I do is I take the toothbrushes in the bathroom, just pop them in the toilet, flush it, and then take them back again, just pop them back in there.
Leave them nothing, leave them out. When they were coming last week, I brought the biscuits to work. Suzanne was like, no one
didn't really?
No mates.
You
no,
brought your biscuits, brought biscuits to work?
No, not no, one that's in, it was just a packet of good quality cookies.
Good quality cookies!
Yeah, you thought I'd be down with
them. Oh, God.
But that's what Suzanne always says, don't know, you know. Why you like this? Because you know it's not as if you've been sort of harmed as a kid or anything.
But I like the fact that you just once said to us that you don't need friends. You don't like friends because they're a bit of a pain. Because they call you up and they want to be with you.
Yeah, but mates are a hassle. I woke up today, right, and I think it was on might have been on 5 Live or something this morning in the bedroom, right, and they were talking about how it's Nelson Mandela's birthday, 80 odd, 20,000 people turning up at his party. I thought I'm glad I'm not in. I couldn't be dealing with that. 20,000 people.
Think of the carpet afterwards. I mean, a good percentage of them were putting out fag butts on his carpet. Yeah, after definitely. Tommy Walsh and Charlie Dimmock, what's her name, did lovely patio and a water feature, he's gonna come back and he's gonna go, oh, it's ruined.
And what's he doing for his birthday? Karaoke? Chinese meal? Bit of karaoke? I wonder what Nelson Mandela's birthday party is like.
Big cake.
Bit of an enormous cake.
Yeah.
The Spice Girls jumping out.
Yeah, the Spice Girls, isn't it? Well, everyone. I don't know. Yeah. We are the only three people that hasn't met him.
Yeah. I thought everyone's file would have been in the cake.
Yeah. Yeah. Just in case, you never know. And if Winnie calls, I'm not here. Have you not invited her? No, of course no, definitely not. Poor Nelson. Happy birthday.
How old is he?
85.
Oh, well done. No, God bless him. God bless him.
Oh.
85 today.
Oh.
Right, bit of Songs of Phrase next then, yeah?
Do you reckon?
Well, really? What's that one?
Play in a minute. Mm. Right. Everybody says that they're looking for a
shelter. Silence is Easy by Star Sailor on XFM 104.9.
Sorry, just suddenly struck me something. I don't know if I mentioned it before. You mentioned, You tried to catch your guy out when you came back once. You opened the door really quickly to see what he was up to. Did I ever tell you when I was at university? Now, I'm very tall and I've got enormous feet. Size 14.
14.
Size 14 shoes. And when I was at university, everyone, it seemed to me, was wearing Dr. Martens. It was like you had to wear a pair of Dr. Martens. It was kind of the rule.
Dr. Martens was too big for you.
Yeah, so that's a big pair of Dr. Martens. That's like, that's where the myth of the old woman who lived in a shoe,
I think, came from.
People with my size shoes. Anyway, I just literally kind of moved to university. I'd been there for like literally a couple of months. And obviously in that first period, you're quite keen to kind of, you know, reinvent yourself, you know, strike yourself, you know, try and give an impression of perhaps being quite sophisticated, worldly, cool. All those things that, you know, you've left behind all your childhood friends, so you're trying to, you know, develop something.
But you didn't bother, you didn't.
What, sorry?
You didn't bother?
No, 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 I was working hard in it, and I was kind of, you know, I was doing alright, you know, and I had my tie-dye shirt, you know, I was looking good. And, so I was trying, you know, working hard to try and seem kind of cool and, not freakish. And, I came back from studies once, and I came in, and there's a little old cleaning lady that kind of would always come in every day and clean up our halls of residence, and I came back, and my, door of my room was open, and there was, like, a little huddle of people just peering in, right? And I went, well, I thought, this is odd, you know, that my door's open and, I'm not in there, and there's people staring in the door. And I looked in, and the little cleaning lady had my Dr. Martens on and was clomping around...
Making them all laugh.
Making them all laugh, doing an impression of me.
That's amazing.
Imagine that! Imagine the psychological scars that has.
I love that the she's more popular than you.
Yeah, exactly.
And they go, come on, Maud, let's go to the JCR. Exactly. And they carry her down. They go, drink, 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 drink. And she goes to you, Steve, you better have that spotless by the time I come back. And you go, all right, I will, all right.
But what I like is the fact that I'm sure that that's not part of the cleaner's code. The cleaner's code is you don't have the keys to everyone's room so you can go through their belongings and play practical jokes. I mean, surely it's a kind of... There's a trust.
She must have looked like a wall bracket. I went bowling with him once the first time, and we went bowling at this place. Where was it? I mean, Finsbury Park. Mm. And I'd never been before. And he goes, you got to wear special shoes. I went, all right. He went, so-and-so. He goes, have you got size 14? And she went, yeah, I've got one pair. And she put them on the table, and they looked like crusty. Honestly, honestly, it looked like... It was. I just started laughing because they're so long and thin anyway, and they're multicolored, aren't they? They're two colors, and it looked like Krusty the Clown's feet. And then this teacher just went, all right, 14. That is big, isn't it?
It is a huge size shoe. You're right. Yeah.
And it was just the one cleaner in them.
Just the one. Sadly.
She did have loads of kids eventually and brought them up in there.
In there.
Well, we got songs of phrase.
Right, songs of phrase then.
Okay, let's just have a look at the prizes. Let's just remind us again what exactly songs of phrase is, because I know a lot of people that put it out of their mind week by week.
It's a phrase that's, you know, been said on the show a few times, right?
Oh, you remember classics like what was?
We've had hairy Chinese kid.
Yeah, there's this hairy Chinese kid.
Stop squeezing my head.
Carl, you're an idiot.
Carl, you're an idiot.
You know, some classic phrases.
Classic phrases. And so you use various old-time songs and you put them all together and that spells out the phrase. Before we play that, let me tell you now, you can win. Look forward to this. What's this? The new album from the Star Spangles. That's called Bazooka.
Is that out, is it?
Never heard
of it. When's Bazooka out?
Never heard of it. The best summer holiday album in the world ever. You've got the treats on there include the Fast Food Rockers and Laz Ketchup.
Yeah. I'm waiting for their second single, because I don't know what that's going to be about.
Sure.
Is it going to be a bit more fast food? Maybe like Pret-a-Manger?
Yeah.
Yeah, lovely.
This is very good. Yeah, two discs set, the best of David Bowie. Inspiral Carpet's the best of them. Still don't know how they spin that over three seasons. No idea.
Bowie's is one.
Yeah. we mentioned it last week, the American Song Poem Anthology. That's kind of a kooky collection of songs. And we've also got a couple of DVDs here. Stephen King's Rose Red. I've never heard of it.
Straight to video.
Yeah, made for television.
Yeah, yeah. And will never be seen at the cinema.
And I know, I mean, I'm sure there's a lot of nerdlingers listening, so they will be loving Richard Dean Anderson in Stargate SG-1. Yeah. Free inside, there's a collector's card, plus you can win some exclusive memorabilia. Brilliant. So I think a pair of...
All you've got to do is listen to these, like, 13 songs, probably, to a well-known stupid phrase.
It's only seven different songs, right?
Well, just get the most you can. Just get the rough artist or song it'd do, right?
And the phrase is, about me dad nicking from, telephone boxes, right?
You've got to give them a clue, because they've got to know what they're listening for. It's hard enough when you know. Dad is never going to stop robbing from telephone box. Is that it?
Yeah.
So what are these songs then? No, go on in.
It doesn't matter that some people don't know what that's about, do they? It doesn't matter.
No, they're not, they're not, well...
Well, your father's a thief.
Email only, ricky.gervais@xfm.co.uk.
Let's hear it.
Also not grammatically correct,
no.
But so it's Daddy never gonna stop robbing from telephone box.
Rubbish.
Unbelievable.
Play it again. I think we just need the song, that's all we're after.
Yeah. Just the song. Right. Daddy never gonna stop robbing from telephone. just again.
Well, this is a desperate feature.
It really is awful. From. See, Rick, if we took more of an interest in this show, we'd have come in, listened to that, and said, we're
no
not
way.
Play it.
We'd have said, no way.
I don't care how long
that.
You spent on it.
We've got a reputation.
Yeah.
We've won awards.
We've won major awards. We're not putting that tat out. But
yeah, no.
You know, that's what.
But we're just giving the listener what they're used to.
Exactly.
So, I think more fool them for listening.
Ricky.gervais at xfm.co.uk.
Eminem. Business on XFM 104.9.
Carl, can I ask, because after last week's show, when you had your breakdown, you went off to Hastings with your girlfriend, stroke carer, Suzanne. Now, what does she... Because whenever we meet Suzanne, we bumped into Suzanne recently at the BBC, Ricky and I. She's always very nice to us, very polite, we have a nice little chat. But I'm always wondering, what is it that she thinks of us, really? You know, because I'm assuming you immediately go home and whinge.
So, but they tortured me. You saw they tortured me on air.
Now, what does she make of us?
Did she listen to the show last week?
Yeah, she did, yeah. She knew I was annoyed.
Right.
So, she sort of gave me a look like... You know what I mean? Like that, when I... Because we went to Hastings.
That wasn't because you had, like, Marmite or something over your face.
No, it was that. So, we didn't talk for a bit. I just was like, you know, getting over it.
Sure.
Thinking, I'm sick of this.
Yeah.
Right. You know, is the new kitchen really worth it and all that?
I phoned him up, left a message after the show. I said, "You seemed a bit quiet when you left. I just want to make sure it wasn't anything I said."
Well, no one.
You're still
doing
your Samaritan.
Yeah. And did it ring or did you just ignore it? Let it go to answer machine.
I think I turned it off. I left it off, didn't I?
Yeah.
Just left it off all day. And
but
that.
What does she make of us? Does she genuinely think? Does she not really like us?
It's weird because there's no one who she doesn't really like, which annoys me, because she says to me, I'm the opposite, do you know what I mean? I'm like, oh, everybody annoys you.
Yeah.
And it's like, well, but that's my choice, right?
Sure.
And that's why I don't bother getting mates and that, because it's just hassle.
Yeah.
But the problem is, sometimes me being like that affects stuff that she wants to do, so, you know, if a mate-
Like see her family and friends.
Yeah. Well, let's not say her family or friends, but say if one of her mates had a baby.
Right.
I mean, you know,
naming no names.
So this happened?
Well, I've just got to watch what I'm doing, haven't I, now? Because of old...
The builder who knows you're slagging him off and saying Indic stuff.
Yeah. So, you know, she's got a few mates who have had kids recently.
Right.
Yeah.
So one of them had a kid, yeah, go on.
Right. And, she wanted to go and see it, right? And she said, you can come with us, and I was like... You know what I feel about babies.
Sure, you've seen one, you've seen them all.
Yeah.
So, they all look like Mal Smith. Why do I need to see another one?
Yeah. Right? And she's like, yeah, but come and see it. You know, you get on with them.
Mm.
Come and see them. And I was like, it's a long way away.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? That's probably narrowed it down again.
Yeah.
You know, so, and that annoys her, because I can't be bothered. Do you know what
did you say? Did you say, oh, no, I'm not coming to see him, I don't
I'm
like
not
him.
Going all the way to Swindon.
What is he? Did he, yeah. Or Birmingham, or Cornwall. Well, you know who you are, if you had a baby.
Yeah,
sort of in the last
time.
And Carl didn't show up. And Suzanne said, what excuse did she say? You're working or busy or?
No, well, to be fair, I was working, right? And they are nice people.
Oh, now you're backtracking, because listen? Do they listen to the show?
They might do.
So you know they listen to the show. So once again, you've got an anecdote where the people who you've admitted to not liking to see their baby or care about them are listening to the show.
No.
Maybe it's, I don't know. Maybe the builder's listening once again.
Nice people, I like them.
Just sneeze in the chili pot.
When the kid's old, they're all going to see him. So
yeah.
Just, you know what I mean? When it's got its own little character. As a baby, it could be any baby. Do you know what I mean? It's got nothing to offer me.
I know what you mean.
It could be a toy baby.
But you know what I mean?
It could be a bag of sugar.
No, I know what you mean, yeah. When it can start talking and, you know.
And lend your mother.
Yeah.
It's got good toys and stuff. It's well worth going, but at the moment,
I see it
when it's about
six. He goes, oh, my new book, yeah, brilliant. Put it to bed, let's have a game of Scrabble.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yes. but yeah, that's what we were talking about on our way to Hastings last week for me. You know, that's where I went to chill after the...
And that's where you decided you couldn't give 100% to the public if you weren't having a good day, like me and Steve do. Come rain or shine on a tin pot radio station, it really doesn't, you know, keep me in frappuccinos these days. we'll say once again on air, this is official, and this is not to put pressure on you, but me and Steve are going away for a couple of months on the 16th of August to do the office special, and if Carl doesn't come back, nor will we, because I see it as a three-way thing, and that's the truth.
Rick, you've said that a couple of times now, as though you're expecting a flood of emails and calls. Nothing.
No, I'm just trying to get in pressure.
There's
because
been nothing.
Because I know for a fact that they want us to come back, and
yeah.
I know.
I think maybe not the listeners though.
No, the listeners don't care.
They don't care.
Could give it, they don't yeah. care. Who stands in? Do you know what I mean?
Incidentally, what frequency is magic?
It's 105.4.
Worth checking out, because I
yeah.
had a great
Heart is 106.2. I think. Virgin's. No, Virgin's 105.4.
Bloody good station.
What is that? 105.8.
Yeah.
Which is
well,
which
check press
good.
For details, but yeah. Or watch some cable TV, there's some good stuff on.
Yeah, Kisses 100, that's easy to remember.
there's a new Ride album out, gentlemen, I think you're probably quite excited. It's,
London's Heart 106.2.
It's released on the 4th of August, and it's all the BBC sessions, all the stuff that Ride did, over the years for-
Virgin. 105.8.
For BBC, and this is one of them. It's called Time Over a Time. I think it was from the album Going Blank Again. It's very good. Play it, Carl. I play that for Pippa, who requested some Ride. That's from a new compilation called Waves, and it's the BBC recordings that Ride made during the 90s, and I think that was originally recorded for BBC Radio 1. That's a good station. Radio
bloody
1.
Good station.
That's a good station if you're interested.
Radio 1. It's one of the...
I think they pay quite well as well.
Well, I enjoyed working for them.
I know we used to work for them for a period of time.
Until we got fired for slagging off...
Simon Mayo.
I think it was Simon Mayo. Yeah. Do you remember that?
Can't quite remember it.
Well, we used to do this thing at Mary and Hobbs at night, and we were getting a bit busy, and so we were constantly handing in shoddier and shoddier work. Right, we used to hand it like that and hand it to them.
A theme
and
there.
A theme, I know, yeah. And to the point where they kept going, oh, like every other week they go, we couldn't put it out. Why? Well, because it was the most offensive, or it was inaudible, or it was twaddle, or you didn't record it. You know, there was things like that.
Yeah.
There. And then I think the straw that broke the camel's back was Simon Mayo had just broken the Guinness World Record for DJing, and we were going, oh, that's brilliant, yeah, in an air-conditioned studio with loads of scroats getting cappuccinos for him. That's not work. Our dad used to bin walls, or build walls, you know, that's work, not sitting down. If he wants to break a record for work, and we went off on things like, I know, we were going, we know birds who do leather stuff to feed their smack addiction.
Yeah.
That's work. Oh, I want to see Mayo on his knees outside McDonald's giving a rent boy a blowjob and all
yeah.
this sort of stuff.
I want to see him hanging up in some kind of leather strap.
In a Amsterdam torture garden with 13 blokes jizzing on him, all with beards.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But why aren't you still there?
oh dear.
Happy days.
I think the producer at the time said, we can't. I said, why not? I said, we're not saying he did it, we're saying we'd like to see him do it,
yeah.
right? And she went, oh, he's a Christian.
All the more. Well, we were talking earlier about friends. You say you don't like making new friends, do you? You're kind of repulsed by the idea of new friends because it's too much responsibility. They might phone you up, they might ask you for a favour, they might need a shoulder to cry on. You don't want any of that responsibility, any of that concern. But I'd say what's worse than making new friends is when old acquaintances come out of the past.
Oh, pop up.
It really unnerves me. Because I'm constantly bumping into people who I just don't recognise.
I know.
And I've got this urge to be polite. I can never just go, I don't know who you are. I've always
Nor
got
can
to
I.
pretend.
I've looked for clues. When they say, you still, don't know, I go, yeah, so I go, right, and what about so-and-so? I go, so they know those two people, and it's like a
yeah.
sort in my brain going, oh, they I must know them from so-and-so.
Yeah. Well, I went back to Bristol once, and I remember walking to the bus stop, and seeing someone I recognise from school and walking all the way to the next bus stop just so I didn't have to stand there and make conversation because I just thought I've got nothing.
Well, it's the conversation
I didn't
the
know
worst
you then.
Bit. If you're moved, yeah, yeah, yeah.
What can we talk about? We've got nothing in common except the fact that we went to the same school. I was
know.
On a train station platform fairly recently and the guy comes in and goes, oh, Steve, how's it going, mate? And I looked at him, stony face, I had no idea it was. But of course, I'd like to go, good, mate, good, how are you? How are you? And, you know, I had a newspaper and I kept looking at the newspaper thinking, every time I look at this newspaper, it's a clue for you to just walk
oh
away.
God.
But he never took the clue. He never took it, so it was kind of, I'd say, oh, yeah, not bad, not bad. Read the paper and he'd go, oh, where you live at the moment? So I'd tell him and he'd say, yeah. And I'd look at the paper again. Oh, do you still know,
But that's what, when you know they are, it's just as bad, because they go, oh, we should have a drink sometime, and you want to go, oh, I'll be honest, look, if I wanted to get in touch with you, I have loads of opportunities.
Exactly.
I've had every day from now right back to the last 15 years, I could have made contact. I didn't.
Exactly.
It's easy. Take that as a clue.
Yeah, I mean,
if
you are listening to this and you perhaps know me from school or university, you're thinking of getting in touch, do not bother.
Ditto! Ditto!
I do not need your friends. I've got enough friends.
Better ones.
Better friends. I've got a number of better friends that I prefer. The reason I've not kept in touch is because I don't really like
you. You've moved onwards and upwards.
Moved on. I know people now, the likes of which have won major awards.
Ricky Gervais, to name but one. He's
happy.
See,
he sat right here next
to me.
That's
all the friendship a man needs.
If you have won 4 BAFTAs, then give me a bell. If you have not, kindly stay in your little underneath your particular rock. Because we're not interested. We have kept you out of our life for a reason. I did not accidentally lose your number. When I promised to send you a letter, it did not get lost in the post. Nothing gets lost in the post.
Oh, yeah, exactly. Carl, what do you think of that?
That's fine, but I'm honest with them though, I assume. Do you know what I mean? I just say, I don't know who you are, can't remember you. Not bothered.
I'm not bothered.
You know what I mean?
Oh, that is genius!
Anyway, Better Darkness.
Oh, well, I've got to play this. Now, be warned, this is a rock ballad off the New Darkness album. I love the album, and it's a bit cheeky playing this, because it's got shades of Def Leppard, right? But there's a lovely balalaika bit in it, and it's quite a nice song. Right? And it's the Darkness, and they can get away with this sort of thing for at least another 4 months. Cardigans, You're the Storm on XFM 104.9. If anyone from Heart or Magic or Radio 1 or Radio 2 is listening, could well be available come October. Alright?
Let's get in touch.
Yeah.
I think that my new TV is too big, Rick.
I said that.
I know,
when
bought I
don't
it. Know what I was thinking.
But I can't believe it. He talked about this buying it. He's got a bit of cash now, of course. And what is it? 42 inches? Mm. 42-inch plasma screen. What did it cost you? £3,000 or something?
I don't know, that's
wow,
huge.
It's ridiculous. £3,500, big spender. Of course it's too big.
Well, I can't get far enough back in the room, in my living room for it.
You know it's 40, you're meant to be, I think, 4 times the screen size away from it.
Really?
To get off in the air. So that's 4 times 42 inches you're meant to be sitting away from it, which is impossible.
Yeah. I'll have to just get friendly with the neighbours.
Yeah, watch it through a hat.
If that's the case, though, aren't you better off just getting a portable?
What?
I don't understand that rule. What are you saying?
Well, you're meant to be 4 times the screen size away from the TV.
Well, that's then what's the point in having a big telly if you've got to keep moving further back? Get a portable.
And sit right next to it.
Is that how they sell it? Is that what they say to you?
Well, no, it's a rule, but I do see your point. Why do people go to the cinema then?
Did you see films that aren't out yet?
Fair enough, he's got you there.
Dom.
I tell you this though, I had it delivered and are you supposed to tip delivery men?
Of course you are.
I don't know, you
said.
I've never had anything delivered before. I've never
spent
that much money.
Not if it's a courier with an envelope, but if it's a bloke who's struggled up the stairs, fat blokes with a fridge, then give him a fiver for a drink.
The problem was, I didn't realise, and I was thinking to myself, I wonder if I've got to tip him, and the guy was leaving. And my mobile phone went off in my pocket, and I reached in to get it. He put his hand out, thinking it was a tip. I went, it's just my phone. I felt terrible after he left. I didn't know. What was I going to do? Run down the street and offer him a fiver?
No.
No, of course not.
No.
Not made
no.
money. I just spent it all on TV.
Yeah, I got no money, mate. Yeah. I just spent it all on this. I had to clean out my jar, everything, the drawers.
Yeah, it takes me bottles back.
What
the problem was, it took me forever to wire it in. I thought, I'm not going to pay for someone to wire it up, you know. So it took me about 3 hours to wire it in, and it was huge. And I got it switched on, and the first program that was on when I got it wired in was Bargain Hunt. I'll tell you this, David Dickinson's tan almost took me eyeballs out.
That's it.
It was incredible. It was like X-rays. Extraordinary,
so
the
close.
Glow.
I know, a huge plasma screen with this orange thing coming out. And he keeps turning to the camera,
course,
doesn't he? Just
green.
To get you. Yeah, he turns away, you get a bit close. They go, what's he doing? He just turns around, takes the cornea off.
What do you think? Bargain Hunt.
Oh dear, well, that's why I'd buy a plasma screen, to watch Bargain Hunt.
I mean, it's ludicrous. This is the problem, is because, what do you watch?
I mean, have you watched anything that's been worth having?
The only thing I've watched really worth watching.
24?
Well, yeah, 24 works great. But also films, obviously, that's the main reason I bought it, because films just look amazing.
Yeah, DVD on the plasma screen.
So you're into films and that, it's just that I only, you know, I've just got the five channels and flicking about. I'm not impressed. I mean, I can understand why more people listen to radio and stuff.
Yeah.
Well, not this one, but go on.
Well, when was it? When was the last time I sort of sat down and had time? Because I'm always busy doing stuff.
Sure. Moaning takes up about 3 hours a day.
Mm. When did Wimbledon finish?
A couple of weeks ago.
Right. Found myself sat there. Right. Like, I'm not having a go. I know we stopped Cheeky Freak of the Week and all that. Right. So I'm not going to be having a go. I sat there.
I'm scared.
No, I'm not having a go, you've always got to remember that.
Come on, just get on with it, I'll apologise after.
I'm just saying, watching Wimbledon, it wasn't, you know, one of the major games, it was little fellas in a wheelchair having a game.
Little fellas in a wheelchair.
Right. But for me, I mean, you know, great, doing sport and everything. Don't put out the telly.
What was up with it?
It wasn't like a rally going on. No, do you know what I mean? Do you know normally,
Christ.
Like, with the not Tim Henman, but with some of the other... with some of the other players and that, they're playing for ages, aren't they? It's like, oh, who's going to win this and that?
Yeah.
None of that. It was just like, hit it, net.
Oh, Christ! Oh, God! I don't know what to do!
And people were, like, sat there watching it as well, when they've got other games going on in there. That's what I couldn't understand. If you've paid your money to get in...
Yeah.
I mean, like I say, good on them if they'd... Do you know what I mean? But it would have been...
And they all start first in the marathon.
I just thought it would have... You know, give them a game of swing ball or something.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
No, yeah, I understand.
Oh, God!
There's never anything
XFM
on.
In the community.
Did anyone confirm? Actually, I had an email earlier.
Swing ball?
No, I'm not having a go, though. Tell them. This is what I'm like, aren't I?
Sorry, this is recording you as well. What do you mean I'm not having to go tell them? Do you think you haven't got a microphone? You just said to London, keep wheelchair sport off the telly because they can't get a rally going. You called them little fellas in wheelchairs. What? And I'm meant to go, what Carl meant was? Well, I mean, what? They can hear you as well.
Yeah, I know, it's just that they might think that I'm having a go and I don't want them to. That's why I stopped Cheeky Freak of the Week because some people got the wrong end of the stick.
Right.
What have you.
So, well, it was funny that a woman was born with deformed legs. They might think you were taking the mech.
So anyway, I just was wondering if anyone could confirm. We had an email earlier. I forget who sent it in, but thanks very much indeed for it. They said that the Paralympics began this week, and apparently during the opening show, the entertainment was provided by Riverdance. Now, I don't know. I don't know if that... I can neither confirm nor deny that, but it does seem rather tactless. Let's play a tune. Ricky Gervais. Ricky Don Gervais. XFM.
Don't put my name to this last link. Don't put my name to this last link.
Ricky Don Gervais, XFM.co.uk.
Oh,
Magic, God. Virgin, if you're listening, we are available probably sooner than we thought.
Making plans for Nigel? XTC on XFM 104.9. Well, you seem a little bit happier. No?
Yeah. It was alright. I'm a bit worried. Like I say, the last thing that we just talked about, I don't want people thinking, you know, we're having a go at anyone, because that, it does do me head in. Because I'm the one who always has to deal with it as well when people do.
What?
You know, we're just talking, having a chat about tennis and stuff.
Yeah, the little fellas in the wheelchair, as you put it. Yeah, what are you worried about? That
just that they think we're having a go and that, because... Sometimes I do have to take calls and deal with it, all this stuff, right? You don't see that. You don't see the hassle I have to go through.
No, but I don't often say things where I'm likely to get a complaint from
someone. But I'm just saying it wasn't meant to be taken badly, do you know what
I
mean?
You're allowed to say you thought that the quality of tennis, because they were confined to a wheelchair, was poorer than, say, Sampras versus Agassi. I don't think that's in question. It wasn't as good a game of tennis. That's what all you were saying. You weren't saying they shouldn't play or...
Wreck the grass. Right mess.
Well, stop while you're ahead.
I'm just saying as well.
I can confirm, incidentally, we've had several emails, I can confirm that Riverdance opened the Paralympics in Dublin recently. So I'm sure that was very good, very entertaining.
Leave it then.
Yeah. No, I'm sure it was entertaining. They're very good.
Was it Jimmy that thought it was short for Paraplegic Olympics?
Really? I've no idea.
Yeah, it's Parallel Olympics, isn't
it?
But as we pointed out, that would be pretty much
Yeah.
Blow football.
Yeah.
There wouldn't be many sports in the Paraplegic Olympics. It stands for Parallel Olympics. I'm educating, Carl. Don't let me like that. I'm educating. I'm not saying funny little fellas in wheelchairs without going up the grass. What?
I'm always educating. I'm always telling you about stuff that I learn about and that.
That you get off Ananova and it's about a monkey who became king.
No. So
is. No? Have you got monkey news this week?
Got a little bit of monkey news coming up.
What does he do? Drive to Spain, rob a bank, or get married?
No, we've done all them, haven't we? We have done all them. Yeah, but you know it's a good one, it's a good one. And in fact, it's a bit related to what we've been talking about, anyway.
Oh, God.
That's good.
Now, okay. Last week, after your nervous breakdown, you went to Hastings.
Yeah.
Can I ask, why the hell did you go to Hastings? It's so arbitrary.
What do you mean?
Why go to Hastings?
You lost him on arbitrary. Why did you choose that above all other places within?
It's amazing, isn't it? You look at his face when you say a word that you know he doesn't understand, and it just goes dead. It's like when your computer freezes.
Yeah, it is like that. Yeah, is there an equivalent to Control Alt Delete when Carl just doesn't understand? So I have to press like knob bollock. Finger up arse. It takes him out of his sort of stupor, doesn't it?
Now that's three things to press, but you've only got two hands, so.
Wow. Yeah, I know. God, what would I do? I'd have the thumb of my right hand, pop that up his arse. I'd have probably my index finger of my left hand on his knob. How would I press his testicles? What would I use? I'd have to use some other part.
Should we try it?
Yeah, let's go around there.
Try messing about.
No, come on. What? Sit down. I just think it's time you had a little kiss.
I've already had a little,
What happened, Carl?
He loves it. I'm just gonna give you a little kiss. That's just for the webcam.
Right, hurry up then.
Alright, on the lips?
No, not
on the lips. Come on.
Oh, God.
I love it because he hates it so much.
You wouldn't get that radio on.
But it makes I could have kissed Chris Moyles.
What?
I could have kissed Chris Moyles on radio.
Little Milesy. Give Milesy a little kiss for all his good work.
Do you enjoy that?
Yeah, it's good, yeah.
What happened to Chris Moyles' show? Is it not on anymore?
On the TV?
Yeah.
No. Turns out he was too fat and talentless.
Yeah.
Do you want to tell us about Hastings?
Where did that come from?
Eh? What?
Yeah, Hastings. Yeah. It's alright, yeah.
What's there?
Not much. It's just one of them
is there
places.
A beach?
Yeah, yeah, it's good. I think that's what's good about it. Nobody knows, right? Because last weekend it was roasting and you saw pictures of Brighton and it was heaving.
Yeah.
Right? Hastings. Hardly anyone there. And yeah, it's got a nice little beach.
Yep.
Sand?
Sandy
no,
beach.
Pebbles. Well, that's alright, isn't it? You don't want the sand.
Why didn't you want sand? What do you want?
It's a little bit, don't it?
It's murder building a sandcastle.
No, you just sit there.
Yeah, you can't walk on pebbles, can you? It's, you know, well, it's all kind of, it's sort of a bit, you know, dodgy underfoot.
It's alright. The only annoying thing is, right, it's one of them places that it's great to visit for a day.
Yeah.
But I wonder how people who live there get by.
Right. Why?
Because all the shops are like them things that you go in and it's like a little pebble with a pebble stuck on the top and it says Hastings on it.
Yeah.
So every shop does that. If you want bread and milk,
you're done for.
It's murder.
Yeah.
There must be a supermarket.
I didn't see any. Seriously, it's all novelty things like that.
Yeah,
and then when I got back into London.
Their houses.
Yeah.
Just covered in pebbles and like seashells and stuff.
Oh, not rock for tea again.
Well, the funny thing is, right, it's the first time I sort of noticed somewhere like that, when you go, what do you do if you, you know, you just want some Brillo pads or whatever. I'm walking in London.
Never concern me that. Never needed Brillo pads in my life.
No, but you know what I mean, the sort of things that,
yeah.
It's a bit tricky to find, but in London, you know, you've got the coverage. Yeah. Now, the weird thing is, I was walking home from, had a drink the other night, right, walking down the road, and there was a shop that just sold, in London, just sold chess pieces.
Yeah. Is that the one on Great Portland Street?
Round the corner from it.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, that's. I think that's mental.
I remember being in Brighton once and seeing a shop, and all it sold was the foam you put inside cushions.
Yeah, there's one of those up Pentonville Road.
But I don't know who opens a shop.
I know where these things are.
There's a hole in the market.
Yeah. What was that shop we walked past yesterday? And it was like something really, really. Chef uniform shop.
Yeah.
It's Dundee Street. Yeah. I tell you what, I opened a chef uniform. Mainly sort of check trousers and white hats. But there must be a lot of chefs around. I'm eating all the time. Someone's making the food.
Yeah.
The funny thing is, on the chess shop, right, they mustn't have been doing that well. And someone must have, you know, the businesses, the bosses must have been sat there going, not really working this, is it?
Yeah, right? People only buy one chess set in their life.
Yes.
Right. Yeah, but the funny thing is, on the door it's just said, come in and browse. Which I thought was odd.
Did you?
No, it's shut. Right. but the funny thing is, right, so you can imagine them sat there going, oh, not doing that well. And it's changed, they've actually changed the name of the shop now.
Yeah.
And now it says chess and bridge.
Right, they've had to expand.
So they've opened it up a little bit.
Yeah.
But still.
What do you buy for bridge, if not
a pack of cards? I don't know.
I don't play bridge, but I don't know. I don't think you need a lot of stuff for bridge except a pack of cards.
I remember going
a table.
When I was on
three friends.
On holiday once in Devon, past a shop. I don't know. If you ever need it, if you ever need an antique marionette, let me know. I know where there's a shop.
Okay, yeah.
Antique marionettes!
I know.
Again, you only need one, unless
you're
a collector.
But I want to know who goes into this business. Well, son, what are you doing? Going to university to do law, father. Well, there's a factory there that makes the little plastic bits that goes on the end of chair legs. Do you want to take it over from me? We're not really, no. It's all set up.
Yeah.
It's all set up. Oh, God. All right, Dad, but just for a couple of years.
Someone's got to make them. Someone's got to make the little plastic bits that go on the end of chairs.
Well, if you make them, call us on the 1234 9734.
Weird, though, innit? Weird, though, innit? Right, listen. Songs of Phrase answers next. We'll go.
Well, I'll tell you what. Play it once more so that people have got a chance to actually enter.
Hang on. Keep talking.
Oh, I can't be.
Should
bothered.
Be ready, Carl. This is terrible.
Here we go. From. Right.
That is the well-known phrase, Daddy's never gonna stop robbing telephone box. The well-known phrase.
And we're looking for, the songs, I think. What? I don't care.
Right. Well, tell me where it all went
wrong. Libertines on XFM 104.9. I'm Ricky Gervais. With me, Steve Merchant. Over there is Carl Cayman Pilkers. I'd be great for Heart.
You really
would.
Wouldn't
I?
You really
Virgin,
would.
I'd probably. But it was Radio 2 would be my first. Oh, great, all one. Late Night station. One would be good.
All good stations. All professional stations.
Yeah. Four weeks to go. Before we may give up or we may come back. Who knows? It's all up to Carl Cayman Pilkoids.
Can I just extend an apology? I was a little bit crass earlier and I made some unsavoury remarks about Radio 1 DJ Chris Moyles. I'd like to apologise.
Funny man Chris Moyles.
I'd like to apologise for that, but it gave me an idea. You, the listeners, who do you hate? Email in ricky.gervais@xfm.co.uk. I just think that we've never really used XFM as a kind of, well, as a research tool, really, and it seems to me that we can get great opportunities.
And it's this, we don't sort of do this thing, we don't go on there and sort of like slag off other people and people in the public eye. Well, we pick on targets that can't
fight back.
Helpless, the elderly, you know, people suffering in some way that really, really, and particularly we don't want to pick on people like Chris Moyles, who's got a big platform, much bigger platform.
We want people who can't answer back.
Yeah, so who do you hate?
That's us. Who do you hate? And I don't want people you went to school with or your
boss.
Do
you know what I hate, Steve?
Who do you hate, Rick?
Right, my top three, just in your top three, would be Hitler, Mussolini, and General Pinochet.
Really?
No, probably Moyles-y, Harry Potter, and Jamie Oliver.
Nice.
But what are your top three?
Now, don't make them comical, don't make them- These are the people that wind you up. When you see them on TV, if you hear them on the radio, if you see them in a magazine, they just- Oh, they make your kind of blood boil.
Might be us.
It could be us. I mean, I'm expecting that.
We know that we- We're not stupid.
We could take it as read that it's us.
Yeah.
And then it's
let's assume it's us, so we want other people. Yeah.
But we just want- I want to draw up the top five people-
I don't want to hear things like Tony Blair and Jeffrey Archer and fascism.
No.
Just people who make your flesh crawl for no fault of their own.
Well,
but really,
well, sometimes their own because they're talentless or fat.
But that'd be good. But that'd be a good long-term poll when, over the next 4 weeks. And then in 4 weeks' time, we go. Well, we're off. We're in the top 10.
Exactly.
But here are the other 9.
So I think it's just genuinely going to be quite interesting. So ricky.gervais@xfm.co.uk.
Maybe who you hate and why. It's like giving a reason in the diary room.
Yeah.
You can't just nominate someone. You've got to say and why.
Sure. But if you can't be bothered to write and why, just nominate.
Yeah.
Because that means just we've got a lot of reading to do if they start doing that, Rick.
Yeah.
Keep it down to one sentence.
Yeah. You know, so the reason to be, you know, so-and-so, because they can't walk. Something like that.
Sure.
Maybe.
Now then, we were playing earlier Songs of Phrase. We have had, I mean, the answers, I could literally count on the fingers of one hand. now, the right answers, even less so. But, do you want to play it once more, Carl?
Oh, God.
from
there was seven songs in there.
Right.
Read them out, go on, what are they?
It was,
Oh, have you got it written down?
No, I can remember them. Daddy Cool.
Right? Boney M.
Boney M.
Yeah.
Never Gonna
Give You Up, Rick Astley.
Yeah.
Write them down!
Stop, Sam Brown.
Right.
Robin was, Miss Robinson by Simon and Garfunkel.
Mrs. Robinson.
Yeah. Hang on a minute. That's not Robin.
Oh.
From Russia We Love, Matt Monro.
Right.
Telephone. Telephone, hanging on the telephone, Blondie. Right. And then Box. Living in a Box.
Living in a box.
Well, listen, no, brilliant. I don't think anyone got them all right. No. If you did get them all right, I'm sorry, but I gave up checking the emails a long, long time ago. So, I'm gonna give it... I'm gonna give it to Michelle Flower, because she got a few of them right.
So, well done, Michelle. She got a lot right, though. Actually, yeah. Well done.
Good, well done.
She got five out of seven, so well done, Michelle. And, you get all those great prizes. Incidentally, we mentioned that, Stargate SG-1. I'm sure you look forward to that, Michelle. That features, Richard Dean Anderson. Had a lot of emails, people saying, is that the same Richard Dean Anderson, or Dickie Anders, that used to email in and said he loved the show?
What's happened to Dickie Anders?
No, I've not heard from Dickie for ages. So, Dickie, if you're listening, Richard Anderson, if anyone knows Richard Anderson, what's happened to him?
Well, I think we know his top three.
Yeah. So, Dickie Anders, if you're still out there, get in touch with
Anders. Anders, it was also right. Yeah. Anders.
I just was going to say, you know, you're talking about people who annoy you, and that.
Yeah.
Like, not many sort of celebrities annoy me because I think, well, some people like them. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But things that affect me, like the builders. Right?
You're a philosopher. Go on.
The builders annoy me, right?
Sure.
Yeah.
And you could say that's a bit of stereotyping, but all the people who have met who have been builders have always annoyed me, right? So that's...
That's because they've been working on your house, in your space. I mean, that's not... That's like all the builders that have been round your flat making a noise when you're trying to get some sleep have annoyed you.
Well, that...
Brilliant.
But also someone in the office in the week, right, who works here.
Yeah.
He's a good lad, named Lenny, right? It's called Lenny. He proposed to his missus using XFM. So,
what,
like, he popped in Zoe's show. Right, his girlfriend sat out there, she didn't know what was going on, she was after coming.
Even she wasn't listening, she was out there. she probably had a Walkman on or something.
Yeah. But just that
she was listening to Jono. He had to fax Jono with the request.
Dear Jono, I'm broadcasting from Mexico at the moment.
My girlfriend's listening to you.
Oh, God. London's hard won a 6x2.
Great stuff.
But it's just that thing of, like, abusing your position, I think, annoys me. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because I just was thinking, if he worked for a cab company, would he have done that over...
That's one of my hates, people abuse. Do you know what I hate? Dictators who have just sort of, like, they've got there by unfair means, now they're sort of, like, hurting the, like, little people and that.
Really?
Yeah, that's what I hate that... the most.
Yeah, yeah. Do you know what I don't like?
What?
Famine. No, it winds me right up. Famine and disease. Oh, you're so annoyed with it. Tune from Wilco, this is called I'm the Man Who Loves You from their album Yankee Hotel Foxtrot. XFM 104.9. Who do you hate? Ricky.Gervais at xfm.co.uk.
Alright.
Fascists. I didn't want it all. Isn't that brilliant? Van Dando, All My Life. Beautiful. On XFM 104.9. Well, that's nearly it. It's the big one. It's what people tune in for. They probably tune in about 10 to these days. For Monkey News. With, Carl Pilkington.
Can we hear the jingle?
Only four to go. Oh! Chimpanzee, that Monkey News!
Right, this one's about a, it's been emailed into me.
Right.
I haven't really had time to check it out this week.
No, you're joking.
Been busy.
Ooh,
been busy.
I hope it's not stupid.
Goes back to 1908, and the person saying it's, you know, it's a good story and that, and they're surprised they haven't picked up on it yet, right? The Olympics, right? In 1908 in London. Apparently, it was meant to happen in Italy, but it was cancelled. Don't know why, right? And it happened in London. Anyway. 400 metres, right, it was meant to, there was a fella who was going to do the run, right, and the favourite to win it was this Bulgarian guy, right? It was like a new
Okay, there's a few things it cannot be. One, he injures himself so a monkey steps in and wins. Two, he does a drugs test, it turns out that he is a monkey. So if it's either of those, right, I'm gonna go mad.
So anyway, so the fella, right, this favourite, everyone's putting the money on him, thinking, yeah, he's gonna do it, gonna
Is he hairy? Is this bloke hairy?
So anyway, so the race happens.
Yeah.
And everybody's lined up, ready to run. And, you know, everyone's saying, yeah, he's gonna win, he's gonna win. Then suddenly, a bit of murmuring going on, people going, oh, what's going on here?
Mm, right. He's eating a banana.
And there's a fella in the lane next to him.
Yeah.
Right, he's going up. Who's that? He doesn't look familiar.
Oh, Christ, Carl.
Chico.
Right, doesn't look familiar. Who's he?
Yeah.
You know, what's going on?
Yeah, what is it? What is it? Who is it? I mean, not what is it?
So they go in. So they say, well, he might not be that any good, do you know what I mean? He might not be good, he might-
just a bit short, anyway. He's only 3'6", and he's hunched over on his knuckles, so-
I didn't realise it was fancy dress.
Yeah. So I don't think he's gonna be any good.
So the race starts-
Oh, he's put his finger up his arse. That's weird for a runner to do that before a race. It's weird, yeah.
Race starts.
Yeah.
The fella that no one recognises wins it. People go, what's gone on here?
Yeah, sure.
Do you know what I mean? We had our money on the favourite, what's gone on? Who is this guy?
Yeah.
Anyway, he stood up there, right? He's looking well happy.
Yeah.
He's lifting the trophy and everything.
Right. Okay.
Long arms, that trophy's higher than-
So anyway,
he's only 3 foot, but the trophy's 9 foot in the air with those long arms. I'm suspicious, go on.
They had the picture in the paper the next day.
Sure.
And everyone's going, yeah, he was fast and everything, but quite hairy for a runner.
Oh, I'll tell you what,
quite hairy for a runner, because normally they shave themselves, don't they, to make them faster.
No.
And how did he manage it? It's really hairy and that. So anyway, he wins the stuff, he walks away with a cup. The people who are in charge of the running, or like the Olympic committee, look further into it. Turns out it was a chimp.
Right, keep talking.
No, don't keep talking.
Shut up, this is monkey news. If you can't handle the news.
It's news from 1909 and I haven't heard about a chimp winning the Olympics.
Right, be quiet.
What happened there then?
400 metres, right? Now
Don't
the thing is-
Don't talk shit.
The
Please,
only thing was,
Ricky.
It took so long for the Olympic committee, right, to find out that it was a monkey. It was going manic. It went into loads of races, it was picking up loads of, like-
No, shut up!
Right? It became a celebrity, it was doing endorsements on TV.
Don't talk shit!
It said, he managed to win the same race 4 years later in Athens because-
How did he get to Athens?
But it's a joke! They're winding you up, Carl!
Weird.
It's not weird, it's in- Right. I do not believe it. Well, that's okay. There's only three of them to go then. Right, because we're probably all leaving in 4 weeks' time, and that's the end, I've got to get onto a sort of mainstream radio station, because I don't think there's any other sort of tin pot place like this, is there?
No.
So I'm gonna clear up my act a little bit. I've got an album from the, Capitol Radio Library, and it's the best, punk album in the world ever, so if Capitol are listening, I'm just gonna show that I can do a mainstream. I'm gonna play a classic song and I'm gonna announce it and everything.
If you get a job on a decent station, you'll take me with you, will you?
We're a pair.
Brilliant.
So, okay, here we go, right. If anyone's listening, just to show that I can do mainstream radio, okay? Well, that's all. Okay.
Well, you're getting nervous. Come on. Shall I get a monkey and do it?
It's alright, it's alright. Okay. Well, that's about all there is time for today. You've been listening to Ricky Gervais with me, Stephen Merchant. Across the way, K-Man Pilkers. We're going all the way back now, a classic song from the late 1970s, and this is Devo with Mongoloid.